In this video, you will see the termination process using Fiber Instruments Sales' Armordillo 3mm splice-on connector using the Fujikura 62S Core Alignment Fusion Splicer. Here are the items needed. Fujikura CT30 cleaver, FIS Universal SOC oven, SOC holder, 3mm cordage holder, crimp tool, Kevlar shears and tri-hole stripper, cleaning solution and wipes, screwdriver. Before any splicing, an important practice is to calibrate the Fusion Splicer. This is called an arc calibration. On the 62S, press the menu key, scroll over to window number 5, and select arc calibration. Prepare and load left and right fibers into splicer. This must be done using single mode cable. When fibers are loaded, close the lid and begin the arc calibration. Once power and position is good, the machine is successfully calibrated. Now, let's set up the machine to splice the Armordillo 3mm splice-on connector. First, let's select our fiber type. Press the menu key, select splice mode. Select single mode auto. Once selected, press edit mode button. Scroll down to proof test. Press the select button to turn off. Turn on the universal SOC oven. Make sure the time is set to a 3mm splice-on connector, 30 seconds. Next, remove both fiber clamps from the splicer. Remove the alignment tool from the CT30 cleaver. Place the boot crimp onto the end of the boot and slide the boot onto the cable. The larger opening of the boot and crimp should face towards the end of the fiber where the splice will be made. Next, slide the brass crimp sleeve onto the cable. Using the provided strip chart, mark and remove 35 millimeters of the 3mm outer jacket. Use the shrink sleeve to hold the Kevlar back as you place it on the cable. Next, mark the 900 type buffer to 5mm. Strip, remove all of the acrylite coating, and clean. Next, place it into the cordage holder as shown. Place into the cleaver. Make sure the 900 micron buffer is against the pad and not resting on it. Cleave the fiber. Once the fiber is cleaved, load the holder into the splicer. The cleaved fiber should rest inside the V-groove. Remove the dust cap and protection sleeve from the SOC and load it into the SOC holder. Be careful not to nick the end of the fiber. Place into the right side of the Fusion Splicer. Close the lid and begin the Fusion Splice process. After achieving a successful splice, open the clamp of the cordage holder and carefully remove the back end of the cable from the cordage holder and pull up and away from the SOC connector. This will prevent the fiber from breaking. Do not hold onto the connector. Slide the splice sleeve down while holding on to the Kevlar. Place the connector into the holder of the oven and adjust the sleeve up against the connector post. Close the lid and press the start button. Once the speed of the blinking light increases, the cooling process has begun. Once the light stops blinking, the heating process is complete. Allow the sleeve to cool down for 2 to 3 minutes. Once cool, pull up the crimp sleeve and capture the Kevlar over the connector post as shown. Follow the crimp diagram on the back of the strip chart according to the style connector. Crimp both connector and cable end of the brass crimp sleeve. Remove any excess Kevlar. Slide the boot all the way toward the end of the connector until the crimp sleeve is no longer exposed. Crimp the back end of the boot. Apply the outer housing. You have successfully spliced the FIS 3mm Armordillo Splice-On Connector.